Welcome everyone. Let's start a new chapter today. If you are a science student, then this term is very common to say in the textbooks. That is thermodynamics. What is thermodynamics? Thermodynamics is basically the study of the heat changes or energy changes involved during any physical or chemical process. Thermo mean heat, dynamics mean flow. So study of the flow of the heat inside or outside the system in case of any physical or chemical change, that is called as thermodynamics. But if we talk about only study of the energy changes during any chemical process, mean we are just discussing one branch of the thermodynamics, then that branch will be called as the thermochemistry. In thermochemistry, we deal with the study of the energy changes involved during any chemical reaction. So the physical changes are not our topic of the discussion. Only we will discuss the heat change or energy change in any chemical process or chemical reaction. The subject matter of the thermochemistry are the thermochemical reactions. Now, what are thermochemical reactions? Those balanced chemical equation in which you see some reactants are changed into the products, and at the end of the reaction delta H value is given, those reactions or those equations are called as the thermochemical reaction. So thermochemical reactions are basically simple chemical reactions. They are chemical reactions, but when we discuss these reactions, our main focus is how much heat is evolved or absorbed during this reaction. And one of the feature of the thermochemical reaction is that whenever you will see any thermochemical reaction in a book, the value of delta H will be given with it. Now these thermochemical reactions may be of two types. They may be exothermic or they might be the endothermic reactions. What are exothermic and endothermic reactions? This is our topic for the today, and we will detail these two reactions. We will discuss these two reactions in detail. In any chemical reaction, the reactants are changed into the products. And that reaction mixer in which the reactants are changed into the products, that reaction mixer is our system. In thermochemistry, you will see a term system. System simply means the reaction mixer that we are studying. And anything other than system in the universe, that will be surrounding. It and surrounding will not be under our consideration. We will be discussing only system. So reactants change into the products in a system. Whenever the reactants change into the products, the bonds in the reactants are broken down and the bonds in the products are formed. You know that bond breakage always requires energy and bond formation always releases energy. It means during any chemical reaction, energy is absorbed as well as released. Now the question is, from where this energy comes, which breaks the bonds in the reactants? Basically, this energy is taken from the surroundings. And when the energy is released, where this released energy goes, this released energy also goes to the surrounding. So the exchange of energy basically takes place between system and the surrounding. If energy is required, that will be taken from the surrounding. And if the energy is released, it will move into the surrounding from the system. Now, whether a reaction will be exothermic or endothermic, this depends on this factor, relative amount. Relative amount of energy absorbed and energy released. It is very simple to understand. Suppose that we are discussing a reaction in which the bonds in the reactants are stronger as compared to the bonds in the products. Mean the bonds in the reactants are stronger and the bonds in the products are weaker. Then what will happen? More energy will be taken from surroundings to break the stronger bonds, and when the weaker bonds in the products will form, less energy will be released. Mean the intake of energy from surrounding is greater than outcome of the energy towards the surrounding. So in this case, when we say that intake is greater as compared to outcome, this process is called as the, or this reaction is called as the endothermic reaction. So always keep the first point in your mind that in case of endothermic reaction, the bonds in the reactants are stronger as compared to the bonds in the products. That's why more energy is absorbed, less energy is released, because more energy is absorbed, so overall absorption will dominate and the reaction will be endothermic reaction. So in case of endothermic reaction, what will be the direction of the flow of the heat? That will be from surrounding into the system, because we have taken more energy from the surrounding as compared to the energy released to the surrounding. And let us reverse this. If the bonds in the reactants are weaker and the bonds in the products are stronger, then what will happen? The lesser energy will be required to break the weaker bonds, while more energy will be released in the formation of the stronger bonds. So energy intake will be lesser, but energy given to the surrounding, that will be more. Mean in this case, the emission of energy or the release of energy in the form of heat, that will dominate. And these reactions will be exothermic. And in exothermic reaction, the bonds in the reactants are always weaker as compared to the bonds in the products. And the, what is the direction of the flow of heat? That will be from system to surroundings. So that will be the exothermic reaction. Now when I say that some of the energy is released, what does it mean? In case of exothermic reaction, the reactants will be at higher energy level and the heat content of reactants is shown with the symbol H1. While the products will be having lesser energy, and when I say energy, there are so many forms of the energy, but in this particular case, we will be talking about the heat energy. So the heat energy of the products will be lesser. Some of the energy will be released from system to the surroundings. So I can simply write it down that H2 is less than H1. If H2 is less than H1, then delta H is equal to H2 minus H1. H2 is smaller, H1 is greater, so the value of delta H will always be negative. Or I can also say that delta H will be less than 0. And this one is a sign of the identification of an exothermic reaction. Whenever you see any thermochemical reaction written and you see that the delta H written is negative, so this reaction will be basically exothermic reaction. In case of endothermic reaction, now what will happen? You can easily see that in case of endothermic reaction, the heat content of the reactants are less and some of the energy is absorbed from the surroundings. When the energy is absorbed, so the energy continuously increases and the heat content or the energy of the products is greater than the energy of the reactants, and that difference of the energy is taken from the surroundings. So in this case, I will say that delta, first of all, I will say H2 is greater than H1. So delta H is equal to H2 minus H1, and delta H will be positive, or you can say that delta H will be greater than 0. And this again, if you simply want to identify whether a reaction is exothermic or it is endothermic, just look at the symbol of the delta H. If it is positive or greater than 0, that will be endothermic. Negative or less than 0, that will be exothermic nature. The next point, when I say that the heat content of the reactants are more and heat content of the products are less, you know that energy is inversely proportional to stability. So the reactants that have more energy or more heat, they will be less stable, and the products that have lesser heat, they will be more stable in case of an exothermic reaction. But in case of an endothermic reaction, the energy content of the products are greater as compared to the reactants. So, because energy content of the products are greater, so they will be less stable as compared to the reactants. This one is the next difference of the exothermic and endothermic reaction. Now, in case of exothermic reaction, most of the exothermic reaction, they move towards stability from high energy to low energy. So that's why most of the exothermic process, not all the exothermic process, they are basically the, you can say they are the spontaneous process. And in case of an endothermic process, because it moves from stability to instability, so that's why these are mostly non-spontaneous process. Non-spontaneous mean we will have to give energy to perform an endothermic reaction. In case of an exothermic reaction, the next difference, whenever you will be sitting near an exothermic reaction or a system that shows exothermicity, you will feel hotter. Just like you are sitting beside a bonfire, then you will see or you will feel the hotness there. But in case of an endothermic process, the surroundings are always cooled down. The surroundings are cooled down and you will feel cooler, just like when you are sitting, you can say, beside a pond or lake. So near a pond or lake, evaporation takes place, and evaporation is a cooling phenomena. So that's why you feel that the breeze is very cool in near the endothermic process. In case of an exothermic process, now look, this point is very important. Suppose that this one is a test tube in which a reaction is going on. This reaction mixer is our system, the test tube and everything else in the universe that is our surrounding. So, because the reaction is exothermic, energy is released from the system. When energy will be released, you will see that the temperature of the system will first increase because the energy is released. And when this released energy will move to surroundings, then the system of the, then the temperature of the system will decrease. So listen very carefully. In case of exothermic process, the temperature of the system first increases, then decreases. But in case of an endothermic process, or in case of an endothermic reaction, this one is a reaction mixer. First of all, the energy required, that energy will be provided by the molecules of the system. When the molecules of the system will provide energy which is required for the reaction, then the temperature of the system will decrease. But in order to compensate that energy which is given by the molecules of the system, some of the energy will be taken from the surroundings. And when some of the energy will be taken from the surroundings, then the temperature of the system will again increase. So in case of endothermic process, the temperature of system first decreases, then increases. And all these temperature changes can be easily measured by using the thermometers. Next point. What are the common examples of the exothermic and endothermic processes? We see so many common reactions taking place which are exothermic, just like you can say combustion, that is always exothermic, neutralization, that is always exothermic. The reaction between a metal and an acid, a reactive metal and an acid, that is always exothermic. The reaction between a non-metal and the oxide of a metal, that is also exothermic in nature. In case of endothermic reactions, there are so many endothermic reactions, like all thermal decompositions, they are examples of the endothermic reactions. Then in case of biological systems, you can see that photosynthesis, it takes energy from the sun, so it is an endothermic process. But the respiration, cellular respiration that takes place inside the cell, it produces energy, so that will be an exothermic process. photosynthesis is endothermic and respiration is exothermic process basically. These are some examples of the exothermic and endothermic processes which involve the chemical change. But in case of physical change, there are so many examples. Just like if I write down that solid, liquid and gas. Now these changes will be discussed in the thermodynamics. These changes do not involve any chemical change. Suppose that a solid changes to liquid, phase change, simply phase change. This process is called as melting. A liquid changes into gas, this is called as evaporation. And if a solid directly changes into the gas, this is called as the sublimation. Whenever you will move from solid to gas, all the phase changes will be endothermic in nature. Whether it is melting, it is evaporation, or it is sublimation. But the reverse of all these, when you change gas into liquid, this is called as condensation. And when you change liquid into solid, this is called as freezing. And when the gas directly changes into the solid, this is called as deposition. So all these processes, the condensation is reverse of evaporation, freezing is reverse of melting, and deposition is reverse of sublimation. So all these processes will be exothermic in nature, but these will be physical changes. They will not be the chemical changes. Similarly, in case of endothermic process, you can say that atomization means to convert a molecule into atoms, that is always endothermic. Then you must have an idea that production of all ions except one, which one? That is the uninegative ion, that is also endothermic in nature. So ionization, that is also basically endothermic process, but the production of uninegative ion, that is exothermic. Why it is exothermic, you can see my video lecture of the ions to have more concept of this. Now what about the entropy in case of exothermic and in case of endothermic reactions? How the entropy changes? The in case of exothermic reactions, the disorderness, solid to liquid, liquid to gas, the disorderness increases in case of endothermic process. So entropy increases, but in case of exothermic process, the disorderness decreases. So you can say entropy also decreases. Entropy simple means disorderness. Take a spring and pull it from both of its side, it will be straightened, and this will decrease the disorderness of the spring. So we will say that entropy has also decreased. So entropy is simple disorderness. This was a comparison of the exothermic and endothermic processes. You must keep this very basic lecture in your mind. And there are so many MCQs that can be asked, whether this process is exothermic or endothermic. And you must keep the difference of the exothermic and endothermic process in your minds. Next time, inshallah, we will come up with the second lecture of the thermochemistry. Till then, Allah Hafiz.